Welcome to another Tutor Short provided by the Educational Support Services Department at Lehigh Carbon Community College in Schnecksville, PA, just outside Allentown. These videos cover key concepts for math and other math-based courses here at LTRI-C. Please remember that the Educational Support Services Department does provide walk-in tutoring 5 days a week in math and other subjects. Integers. This will include adding integers, subtracting integers, multiplying and dividing integers, and exponents. First, with adding integers, you add integers with the same sign by adding the numbers and keeping the sign. So a positive plus a positive is a positive. And a negative plus a negative equals a negative. Adding integers with different signs, you subtract the numbers and keep the sign of the larger number. So some examples. Negative 16 plus negative 20. Both of these numbers are negative, so my answer is going to be negative. So then I look at 16 plus 20 is going to be 36. So my answer is negative 36. Now I have 19 plus negative 4. In this case, my signs are different. I have a positive 19 and a negative 4. 19 is the bigger number, so my answer is going to be positive. So then I'm going to take my numbers and subtract. 19 minus 4 is going to be 15, and my answer is a positive 15. Next we have negative 7 plus 20. Again, my signs are different. It's a negative and a positive. 20 is my bigger number, so my answer is going to be positive like my 20. So then I'm going to do 20 minus 7 is 13. This answer is 13. For this one, if I had 7 plus a negative 20, in that case, my bigger number is still 20, but it's negative. My answer would be negative, and I'd still do 20 minus 7 is 13, so the answer would have been negative 13. My last example for addition is 8 plus 11. Both numbers are positive, so my answer is positive, and 8 plus 11 is 19. Now on to subtracting integers. Subtracting a number is the same as adding the opposite of the number. So every subtraction problem we're just going to convert into an addition problem. 7 minus 9 is the same as 7 plus a negative 9. I have a different signs, a positive and a negative. 9 is the bigger number, so my answer is going to be negative. And I'll do 9, oops. So negative. 9 minus 7 is 2, so my answer is negative 2. Negative 13 minus 6, this becomes negative 13 plus a negative 6. Signs are the same, so I keep my sign, which is negative. Since they're the same, I just add my numbers together. 13 plus 6 is 19, so my answer is negative 19. Negative 1 minus a negative 5. Is the same as negative 1 plus a positive 5. Signs are different, negative and a positive. 5 is the bigger number. It's positive, so my answer will be positive. And now I subtract my numbers. 5 minus 1 is 4. So this is a positive 4. 17 minus a negative 16 is the same as 17 plus a positive 16. Both are the same. They're both positive. My answer will be positive. 17 plus 16 is going to be 33. So my answer is positive 33. On to multiplying and dividing integers. You multiply or divide the numbers as the problem calls for. If they have the same sign, your answer is positive. If they have different signs, your answer is negative. So 5 times negative 7. 5 times 7 is 35. They had different signs, so my answer is negative. Negative 90 divided by 10. 90 divided by 10 is 9. They have different signs. My answer is negative. Negative 9. Negative 9 times 5. 9 times 5 is 45. Different signs. My answer is negative. Negative 6 divided by negative 2. 6 divided by 2 is 3. They were both negative. That's the same. So my answer is a positive 3. Negative 8 times negative 4. 8 times 4 is 32. They're both negative. That's the same, which means my answer is positive 32. 12 divided by negative 6. 12 divided by 6 is 2. 12 is positive. Negative 6 is negative. That means my answer is negative 2. 5 times 2. 5 times 2 is 10. They're both positive, so my answer is positive. And then 8 divided by 2. 8 divided by 2 is 4. Both of those are the same. My answer is positive 4. Lastly, we have exponents. The power is only applied to the number unless the sign is in parentheses. So first we have negative 2 cubed. This is the same as saying negative 2 times 2 times 2. Cubed means you have 3 of it, and that cubed is only applied to the 2. Negative 2 times 2 times 2 is negative 8. The next one is negative 2 with parentheses around it and cubed. This one means negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. 2 times 2 is 4 times 2 is 8. 3 negative signs. 2 of them cancel out. I'm left with 1, so this is a negative 8. So in this case, it really didn't matter which way I went. I got the same answer either way. That's not going to work on this next one. Negative 3 squared is negative 3 times 3. 3 times 3 is 9, so this is negative 9. Next we have negative 3 quantity squared, so this is negative 3 times negative 3. 3 times 3 is 9, but this time I have 2 negative signs. They cancel out, so it's just a positive 9. For every 2 negative signs you have when multiplying, they cancel out. So make sure you don't confuse the two different ways to do this.